Pat Robertson TV Ministry Workshop was worth every penny. I learned quite a few tricks of the trade. Like, instead of asking for a minimum donation to the Saving Center of $20, we asked for $19.99. See? Sounds cheaper. So, Linda, if we find we have some time to fill and we gotta, you know, improvise about donations, not $20, but $19.99 as a minimum donation. We don't want people to think that's all they need to spend. Not so much starch on those collars, Millie.
60 seconds to the show. Good afternoon. You've reached the Houston Savings Center. This is Millie, your friend in Jesus. How may I help you? The Reverend Jimmy Swagger?
Jimmy Swagger? Lord, what could he be calling for? You think he's seen the show? I bet he wants to congratulate me.
It's not for you. He wants to speak to Linda.
Linda?
Hi, Jimmy. How in the world did you get this number? Tonight? Well, we are about to do a show here.
Ask him to come on the show. Ask him.
Well, Christian television audience, the moment you've been waiting.
Get into town.
Live from the Savings Center in Houston, Texas, it's Minister Mike.
Hello, and welcome to
the Savings Center.
For those of you who don't already know me, I'm Minister Mike. Now, do we have any Christians in the audience tonight?
Yes!
And what kind of Christians do we have?
Self-righteous Christians?
No.
Born-again Christians?
Born again? What? You weren't born right the first time? I'm just kidding. Of course you're born again. People forget that Christians have a sense of humor, too. Speaking of which, boy, oh boy, have we got some first-rate Christian entertainment for y'all tonight. I'll tell y'all about it, but first, let me bring out the lovely, the talented, and truly Christian, Linda Haddix. Come on out.
Christians in our studio audience, and hi to our Christian audience at home.
Linda, you've been with the Savings Center since we first opened our doors here.
Yes, that's right.
Remember that first day? People were standing in line waiting to get in.
Well, now that's because this building used to be a Kmart, and everybody thought the Savings Center was a new discount merchandise store. But, you know, I think the confusion really started when Kmart used the Saving Place as an advertising slogan. Oh, but you know how now everybody goes around saying, attention Kmart shoppers, you know, that illegal alien joke, you know?
Thank you for sharing that little story.
You're welcome.
Tonight, we want to talk a little bit about the desperate need to enforce censorship in our Christian nation.
Pornography and violence have just reared their ugly little heads everywhere you look.
Linda, let's show our Christian television audience how they can help enforce censorship in their own neighborhoods by using a revolutionary idea in censorship. Introducing
the
censor stick. Now hold up your stickers, Linda, so the television audience at home can see.
Censor sticks come in convenient packets, each containing 5 No Christian and 5 No Satan stickers.
With censor stick stickers, even the simple-minded can recognize smut at a speedy glance.
So you don't have to think about it.
For example, Linda, I have here a Playboy magazine. Now, which sticker should we place on it? No Christian or No Satan?
Well, now, that's pretty easy. Any simple-minded boob could figure that one out.
That's right, Linda. no Christian sticker, because Christians have better things to read, like the Bible, Linda.
Well, now, that's pretty easy, too.
Satan's flock will see a no Satan sticker on the Bible and move on to other literature more appropriate for their tastes, like High Times magazine.
Hold on, I think that one needs a no Christian sticker. There we go.
Or Play Girl.
Let's just get a no Christian sticker for Play Girl.
Now, censor stick can be used just about anywhere, at home, the office, or when you're walking by a magazine stand at the 7-Eleven stores. Best of all, censor stick is free
for
a minimum donation of just $19.99.
Use your Visa or MasterCard.
Censorship can be fun for the whole family, and it makes a great gift. Oh, and censor stick is perfect for use in children's public school libraries.
Have you seen these pictures of Jimmy Swaggart's girlfriend? You know, I just don't think she's all that hot.
Please try and keep up.
Well, excuse me for living.
Linda, I have here a book from a typical secular public school library. Now you tell me, which sticker should we place on the classic Catcher in the Rye?
Well, I wouldn't know. I never read it.
Well, of course you didn't. Unfortunately, I did. This boy in the book talks to a prostitute.
Well, now, Minister Mike, what happens if we don't censor the book Catcher in the Rye?
I don't know. Women who read it will become prostitutes.
Just the women? Well, what about the men?
Homosexuals.
Let's put a no Christian sticker on Catcher in the Rye right now.
Well, enough on this subject for the time being. Linda, I believe it's time to see your little video from the Blonde Faith cassette tape.
Oh, good.
Y'all give Linda a big hand and look at the monitor.
Pro-choice, I know you're gonna be upset, 'cause Christians block the entrance to your world. But you should know by now, you shouldn't kill babies. To blow up clinics is far from wrong. Self-righteous Christians are standing strong. You treat us like pesky farts, but we know what we're doing. You taught girls what Pentecost is all about. You said that kids, they can do without. Now Roe versus Wade's a mess, and politicians are sweating. Please, pro-choice, don't preach. You're in trouble deep. Pro-choice, don't preach. Women's libs asleep. Christians have made up their minds. You must keep your babies. You better keep your babies. You gotta keep your babies. You know, Jesus wants you to keep the baby. Keep your baby. You better have that baby. You better keep your baby. La-dee-da-dum-ba-da-dee. Ba-dee-da-dee-ba-da-doo.
Thank you.
Linda, each week you bring such original, quality Christian entertainment to the show.
Thank you.
But there's also a serious side to you here at the Saving Center, isn't there?
Yes, that's right.
Why don't you tell our Christian television audience about your little ladies' club?
Oh, all right. Well, our Babbling for Jesus Club gets together bi-monthly in the parking lot here at the Saving Center. Oh, now the babbling part stands for burn all bad books and lyrics in gasoline.
For Jesus?
Oh, yes, for Jesus, of course. It is a book-burning club, and it's just about the hottest ticket in town. In fact, sometimes a fire department has to come out, and I don't need to tell you girls that most of those firemen are handsome. So it's no wonder that all of our lady babblers show up just bringing station wagons full of Playboys and Playgirls and Cosmopolitan magazines and Hollywood Wives and Alice Through the Looking Glass. Now, Alice Through the Glass, will really any of the hard copies make excellent torches? It is all just so exciting, and I hope you'll all try to join us next time. And those handsome firemen. Well, you know, some of them are actually local celebrities, not to mention very photogenic. In fact, I think I saw a copy of the new fireman calendar right here in this stack. Let me just dig it out so I can share it with you. I know it's right here near the top. You know, Mr. March is my personal favorite. I know it's right here near the top. Let's see. Here it is. In fact, Mr. March has been to put out the flames on several occasions. Now, let me just find Mr. March. So, now, hold on. Wait just a dadgum minute. Did you put a No Christian sticker on Mr. March?
Yes, I did.
Well, why? I mean, it's just a calendar, for crying out loud.
I think this is a real good time to hear a word from one of our Christian sponsors.
Jesus loves me, yes, I know.
Excuse me, miss. Sorry to disturb you, but... It's...
Did you not see the sign on our front door? It clearly says no soliciting.
I'm not selling anything, ma'am. All I'd like is...
I do not have any money.
Well, thank you anyway, ma'am, and God bless you.
Well, God bless you, too. Ugh.
The I Love Jesus air freshener, because sin stinks.
I am putting my life on the line here for you to get to that goddamn oil rubber seminar. Now get out there and block the traffic. This guy's on drugs.
Linda, it is time for this week's Just Like Jesus Award.
Hallelujah.
Each week, a panel from our Christian television audience votes on who will win this prestigious honor. This week's JLJ Award goes to Senator Jesse Helms of North Carolina. Praise Jesus.
Praise Jesse.
Huge.
Thank you.
Linda, as you know, Satan has been financing his own artwork through a federal program called the National Endowment for the Arts.
That pesky Satan just loves spending your tax dollars.
But our Jesse put a stop to that. I had the distinct honor of meeting the great senator.
When did you meet Jesse Helms?
On a recent trip, and he was kind enough to lend us some of his pornographic material to share with our Christian television audience. For educational purposes, of course.
Christians, here is just a small sample of the satanic art your hard-earned tax dollars have been supporting.
The controversial photography artist Robert Mapplethorpe, who, by the way, was a homosexual, certainly had his nerve. Notice these phallic flower stems that remind me of erect penises. Brown ones, black ones, white ones, even little yellow ones.
Oh, now, hold on just a minute. This last one looks more like a vagina to me.
Those aren't the photographs that have Senator Helms in such a tizzy. These are the photographs he wanted you to show. I found them in your briefcase. And hurry up with them because he wants them back right away. He says you can keep the flower ones. I don't know how they got all stuck together.
Yuck. Oh, my. You know, now, this one looks kind of like Mr. March.
Linda, you know, I believe it's time for our live Christian healing segment. Would you care to join me in the studio audience?
Yes, I sure would.
I see a little line of healies and healettes already forming down there. Now, no pushing, please. Jesus has plenty of time for all of you.
This nice young man is Dooley Tackleberry of Houston.
Hi, Dooley. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yes. I'm just really nervous right now. I'm a file clerk with a company that manufactures latex condoms. But I am a Christian.
Praise Jesus. And how can I heal you today?
I want to be right with the Lord. And I want you to heal me of my homosexuality.
So, Dooley's a homosexual. Well, we never would have guessed that, would we, Linda? Put your little arms up, Dooley. Come on. Demon spirits, go on. Get now in the name of Jesus.
Come on, Jesus.
Go on, demon spirits. Out in the name of Jesus.
Come on, Jesus.
Well, son, are you healed of your homosexuality?
I'm not sure.
Look at me and look at Linda. Now, which one of us would you rather fornicate with?
Well, neither.
You're healed.
This is Audrey Widener, who comes to the Saving Center all the way from Pearland.
That's Widener. The I is silent. It's German.
How about if we just call you Audrey?
That's fine.
And how can I heal you today?
Well, Minister Mike, about 6 months ago, I lost 99.9% of my vision.
Oh, nice.
Legally, I'm blind as a bat. Well, you can imagine what it's like trying to take in the laundry. Mm. You see, I do the wash for the women in my neighborhood who have careers.
Mm.
Now, I can handle the washer and dryer just fine without my sense of sight. But so help me, Jesus, the ironing is just wreaking havoc with my hands.
Whoa! Keep those hands up, Audrey Widener. I mean, Widener. Demon spirits, go on and get now in the name of Jesus.
Come on,
go on, demon spirits, go in the name of Jesus.
Somebody help me, I can't get her off.
Minister Mike, I believe Jesus just spoke to me. Does he sound like Richard Simmons?
No.
Praise Jesus, it worked, I can see.
How many fingers am I holding up, Audrey?
Fingers? I see stars. Lots of bright little dots. Look like angels going every which way. I think I see you, Minister Mike. Do you have long hair?
Well, I have volume, but lengthwise, not really.
Oh, then it must be Jesus. Or Linda.
Well, describe what I'm wearing.
A long, white, sort of toga-type robe.
It's Jesus, you see.
It is Jesus, I see. He's motioning to me. He wants me to go with him, to follow him. Jesus is taking me home.
Linda, I believe it's time for Christian viewer mail.
All right, let me just get my glasses on. We got lots of letters from Christians this week.
How nice.
Now, Minister Mike, I have one right here from a Catholic priest. This ought to be good. Dear Minister Mike, I am a Catholic priest who was inspired by that famous artist's work. I hate to say this word. Piss Christ.
Oh.
The art piece that was at the center of controversy with Jesse Helms and the NEA. When I first viewed it and found out the crucifix was photographed in urine, I was shocked. But after contemplating it, I took it to symbolize that Christ's love will prevail even in man's waste. I was touched by the artist's courage and powerful imagery, and feel my own personal faith has grown from the experience. Everyone has their own opinions about art. My question is, what qualifies someone like Jesse Helms to legislate and restrict artists' work? Signed, A Father for Art.
Thank you for your letter, Father for Art. Let me take a wild guess here.
While you were studying for the priesthood in some high-dollar Catholic university, I bet you minored in art. So, with your liberal art education, and being that you're a priest and all, you think you see the good in everything, even our Lord dunked in a jar of pee. Well, let me tell you, Father Art, while you were cutting class being artsy-fartsy, Jesse Helms was building up some mighty high moral fiber. And we all know that it's fiber that makes Jesse quite firm in what is and isn't art.
Amen.
Let's get on to another letter.
Well, this one just came in.
Oh, that's nice.
Dear Miniskirt Mike.
Miniskirt?
That is what it says. I want to see, dear Miniskirt Mike. You are a major jerk. You are as phony as your hair. If Christ ever did return, you would be the first to nail him back on the cross. You feed on people's loneliness and fear as you bleed their pocketbooks. You scream about censoring books and music and art. I am an atheist, yet I, like you, can't stand Ozzy Osbourne or Two Live Crew. My question is, does that mean you and I have something in common? I hope you get run over by a truck. Signed, Over It. P.S. Tell that tramp, Linda, I've seen better dresses in the reject bin at the Salvation Army. Well, of all the nerve.
Hold on, Linda. This idiot has the right to his misguided opinion. Thank you for your letter, It. First of all, what are you doing looking for dresses at the Salvation Army store for? Are you a homosexual and an atheist? And second, I believe you and I dislike Ozzy Osbourne and Two Live Crew for different reasons. They're probably not perverted enough for you. And as far as Linda being a tramp is concerned, remember, Jesus died for her sins, too. Ow, that hurt!
Psst! Psst! Minister Mike! I've got the speakerphone working. We have a surprise Christian celebrity on the line.
A surprise Christian celebrity?
Luscious Linda, is that you, baby? It's Jimmy, darling. It's your old swagheart here. I'm ready to take you around the world tonight, honey. I've got my scuba gear. I am ready for some deep sea diving.
Jimmy, Reverend Swagger, sir, you're on the speakerphone here.
Speakerphone? Whoa!
Reverend Swagger, sir?
Who the hell is that, Linda? What's going on? Where are you?
It's Minister Mike.
Who?
Minister Mike of the Saving Center.
Oh, Jesus the Christ, shit!
Yes, he's here too, in spirit.
Is Linda there?
Reverend Swagger, I'm right here.
Get me off this speakerphone right now!
It's such an honor to receive a call from such a giant in our industry.
Yeah, good.
Do you have any encouraging words for our humble little ministry?
Listen, this is a joke.
No, Reverend Swaggart, I'm afraid that this is no joke.
We must have been disconnected. Millie, check into our phone service here. Well, I can see that we're just about out of time now.
Praise Jesus.
But y'all tune in next week. We need the ratings. Linda, are we gonna sing or what?
Of course.
The minute I wake up, before I put on my makeup, I say a little prayer for Jesus.
A born-again Christian won't tolerate false religion.
I say a prayer for Muslims too. It's Jesus, And Jesus has told me that it's okay, Bob Satan. Yes, Jesus, sweet Jesus, has told me that it's okay, Top Satan. Yes, Jesus, sweet Jesus, has told me that it's okay, Stop Satan, by enforcing prayer in school. Ba-bum, ba-bum, bum, bum. Ba-bum, ba-bum, bum, 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 bum. I say a little prayer for you.
I think the show went pretty well today, don't y'all?
It's to snatch a teenage